Hi dear students, welcome to your English class. I wish all of you be okay. As you remember, we have started our unit 6 in business, and we say that what does it mean? Nothing ventured, nothing gained. We say that venture means taking risks. As you know, in business we should take risks. Without taking risks, we don't gain anything. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. So our today's lesson is vocabulary part. As you remember, we did the exercises, we read the text. So today is vocabulary part. Okay, it says that match the highlighted words in the text with these definitions. As you see in here, we have some words which are highlighted, in here. So let's match the definitions with highlighted words. Word number one: an idea, a plan, or an offer, especially in business. In here, the word proposition. This didn't make his idea a very attractive proposition. Proposition means an offer. Yes, an offer or an idea. So let's write proposition. Proposition. We say that proposition means an idea or an offer. Let's see the second one. It started something new. If we look at the text again, highlighted words. It started something new. Let's see here. A few years later, he launched his own computer consultancy. Launched means started something new. Let's try it. Launch. So launch means to start. Next word, local offices or shops which are part of a large company or organization. Let's find the word for this. Local offices or organization. What do you think? Which one? Branches, yes. Branches is local offices or shops. Let's write branches in here. We did three of them. The rest are your homework. Let's continue to next page. Okay, dear students, in this page we are gonna learn some vocabulary. High flyers. As you remember, we say, what's high flyers? High flyers are those people who are successful in their whole life. It can be a school, it can be job, or any other part of life. So, activate. It says that complete the sentences with the correct form of the words from the box. In here, there are some words. These are highlighted words that we studied before. So, it says that complete the plans with these words. As example, let's do one of them. Number one, his father played an important what? An important capital, an important lucrative what? His father played an important role. So, the correct and the best answer for this is role. His father played an important role. Role means to have a particular position and something. Okay, rule. So the rest are your homework, dear students. Let's continue with the next exercise. Extend. Extend means to spread out, to enhance, to develop, extend, to spread out. And here we have some phrasal verbs which are mostly about business. Words which are used in business, or phrasal verbs which are used in business. Phrasal verbs. What's phrasal verb? As you know, we say that phrasal verbs are combination of two or three words that haven't exact meaning. We can't translate phrasal verbs one by one or word by word. We can't translate them directly. Okay? So branch out, as you know. We can't translate branch, then out. Branch, it means a field, and out, it means out. We can't translate it directly. So, branch out is a phrasal verb. It means to start an activity, a business activity that you didn't do it before. So let's do the others. Take over. What do you think? What does it mean? Take over. So, take over means to begin to have control of another business. Letter E. So let's try it. Letter E in here. Take over. Cutback. Cutback is a phrasal verb. It means to reduce something. So which letter? Letter A. Come up with. Come up with. It means to think of an idea or a plan or etc. It means which letter? Letter G. Turn down. Turn down. It means to not accept an offer or a request. So it is which letter? Letter B. Next one, number 6, pull out of. Pull out of is another phrasal verb which is used in business and it means to stop being involved in something. So which letter? Letter H. And the next one is get ahead. Get ahead, it means to make progress. So it's which letter? Letter C. And the last one, the most difficult one, take on. Take on, it means which one is left? To employ people, yes. Letter D. So, let's continue with the next exercise. Let's clean it. Next exercise says that complete the sentences with the correct form of the phrasal verbs which we have studied in exercise 1. So number 1 is done for us as example number 2. He has a great idea for a new online magazine. He has what? In here, in previous exercise, we have studied some phrasal verbs. We should use one of them. He has what? He has come up with. Come up with. He has come up with a great idea for an online magazine. See in here, has, and we have come. What kind of tense is this? It's present perfect tense. Has plus past participle. As you know, the past participle of come, again it is come. Come, came, come itself. So the rest are your homework. Do them in your home. So let's come to next exercise. Newspapers and magazines. These are the words, the vocabulary that are used mostly in newspapers and magazines. It says that match the words with the definitions. As you see in here, we have about 8 words with 8 definitions. Let's match them together. Number 1 is done as example for us. Article. Article means a piece of writing on a particular subject. So this is called article. Let's do the others together. So caption. Caption, it means a short text and a photo that describes it. So it is which letter? Letter H. Next one is column. What do you think? Which one is it? Column. Is it a piece of writing? Is it the title of a newspaper? It is a piece of writing. So which letter? Letter B. Piece of writing on different subjects which is always written by the same person. This is called column in newspapers and magazines. The next word is review. What do you think? What does it mean? Review. Which one? Is it A? Is it B? Is it C? D? Which one? It is letter F. A report that gives an opinion about a new book, play, film, or etc. in newspapers and magazines. So, review means which letter? Letter F. And the next one is classified ad. Ad is the short form of advertisement. So, see? Classified ad means a small advertisement offering to sell or buy something. Okay? So it is which one? Letter E. Next word is obituary. Obituary means a report which gives news of someone's death and information about their life. So it is with which letter? Letter A. Yes, thank you. Letter A. And the next one is headline. As you know, headline means what? Which one? Which one is left? Yes, letter D. The title of a newspaper article printed in large letters above the story. So, letter D. And the most difficult one, the last one, is supplement. What do you think? Which letter is left? As you see, letter G. So, supplement is letter G, and it means a magazine that is added to a newspaper. So, this is done. Let's continue with exercise number 4. Exercise number 4 says that how many of the parts of a newspaper in exercise 3 can you identify in the picture? As you see, in here we have some newspapers, and in here we learned some words which are used in magazines and newspapers. Let's see which words are used in here. For example, headline. Yes, the headlines are used in this exercise. This is your homework. Go and find other words which are included in this part or newspaper. Okay, these were our today's lesson, English lesson. I wish all of you enjoyed. And don't forget, your homework is workbook page 45 plus this exercise, find the words. And you have another homework and vocabulary part. Have a good night and day. Goodbye.